Hello everyone. Today we will start a new environment, that is a digital mock-up kinematics, that is DMU kinematics, you can say. So we will see the introduction about DMU in this tutorial and what are the joints we are going to use while creating a mechanism. So now, how to start a DMU? So let's go to start, then go to digital mockup option and go to DMU kinematics. So you will directly enter to this DMU kinematics. So you can see from this option also, you can see that digital mockup kinematics workbench. Now we will first understand kinematics. So what is the purpose of it? What is the purpose of DMU kinematics? Again, the first one is to check the actual mechanism or working of the machine parts. So we can first check the actual mechanism of and working of these machine parts in this particular software, and then we will manufacture that part. So again, the second is we can check the swept volume of the mechanism so that we can design a cover to that machine. So we will get this swept volume from this mechanism, and according to that we will design the cover to that machine. So also for the cam like parts we can trace the path of the part. We can trace the path of the part, how it going to work there. So here are the three main reasons we use these mechanisms in CATIA. Then similarly, now how to create mechanisms. So here first we have already seen the assembly. In assembly we constrain all the parts and we make sure that all these degree of freedom in the assembly of the parts is fully locked. But in mechanism we keep some degree of freedom open as per our requirement and as per the functionality of that component. So here we keep the degree of freedom of the parts open as per the functionality in the machine. Okay, so again we keep this degree of freedom open for this. So we cannot create, and we just create first part as a not first part we can just fix one part and then keep open some degree of freedom of the parts. So what is the application of this mechanism? So we use the mechanism that is a 4-bar mechanism, which is having the 4 revolute joints, 4 bar mechanism, which is having the 4 revolute joints, and we provide a motor to the 2-1 joint only. Okay, so this is the application for it. So now we will see what are the joints we use to create a mechanism. So the first joint we use, that is a revolute joint. The second one is we use the prismatic joint. Third, we use a cylindrical joint. Fourth one is the screw joint. Fifth one is spear joint. And last we use the gear joint. So these are the 6 joints we use mostly to create mechanisms. So we will see that one by one. So first we will introduce the important toolbars in mechanism in CATIA. So important toolbars. Customize this toolbar. So go to the tools and then customize that they restore their position. Now go to toolbars and then restore all contents, all the value restored, and then restore their position. I mean this toolbars. Now I will drag this. The space analysis is there. The DME kinematics toolbar. Then this is the update toolbar, that is a kinematics update. So these are the main toolbars and DME kinematics. So here are the all the joints. First one is the revolute joint, second one is the prismatic joint, third one is cylindrical joint, the screw joint, spherical joints, and the planar joint, there is a rigid joint, again the point curve joint, slide curve joint, and the next one is the roll curve joint, the point surface joint, universal joint we can create here, and the constant velocity joint, there is CV joint, the gear joint, the rack joint. So we will see some of them. Another is a fixed part. So to first here also we first fix the first part here, and then according to that we create a joint there. Another is a DMU generic animation. To create a animation of this, we use this simulation toolbar, compile simulation, replay. So again there is a swept volume. We use this swept volume to change the swept volume for this machine mechanism. Again here is a trace to trace the path for this, for the part. So again there is a DMU space analysis here. So here are again two options, that is a flash and a distance and band analysis, and the DMU update. So if you want to update that, it will be updated through this option. So then I will write that. So first one is the DMU kinematics. The second one is the DMU generic animation, ready to create animation files, video files you can create. Then a DMU space analysis to again to shape the clashes or the distance. And then the kinematic update. So to update, we use this option. So we will see all the joints in the next tutorials one by one. Please subscribe my channel and like my videos. If you have any queries, comment below. I will definitely try to solve each of them. Thank you for watching.